21,593 people were killed by earthquakes in 2011. The leading cause of deaths from earthquakes is from collapsed buildings. Our project is called HAWK, which stands for Helicopter Aircraft Wielding Kinect. The goal of Project HAWK is to minimize the risk to search and rescue personnel who are tasked with entering collapsed or unstable buildings to look for survivors and evaluate the structural integrity of those kinds of buildings. We propose to mitigate this risk by, instead of sending people in first, let's first send in a four-rotor remote-controlled helicopter, commonly known as a quadrotor. Let's send that into the building and have it look for survivors and evaluate the structural integrity of the building. We chose to use a quadrotor over a land-based robot because the type of environments we're going to encounter, we're going to have uneven terrain, cracks in the floor. It's not great for a land-based robot. A quadrotor wins it. We equip our quadrotor with a Microsoft Kinect, which is a $150 Xbox 360 gaming device. It consists of a traditional RGB camera, as well as a depth camera. And using only those two streams of data, we're able to construct 3D maps of the quadrotor's environment in real time. These 3D maps have two purposes. The first is to assist the pilot, which sits at a remote base station in a safe location. They use that map to help pilot the quadrotor. They also use that map to give it off to search and rescue personnel once they've located survivors. And I'll turn it over to Paul to talk about the base station.
Excellent. So the Intel Atom on board the quadrotors compresses and streams the Microsoft Kinect data back to the base station for processing. The first thing we do with the raw data is we first display the RGB color camera for teleoperation in, say, a disaster area. And second, we perform a simultaneous localization of mapping, or SLAM procedure, to build maps, three-dimensional maps, in real time as the quadrotor explores its environment. Thanks to GPU acceleration through NVIDIA's CUDA, we were able to achieve a real-time visualization and mapping generation result. So in order to show this off to you, we'd like to do a live demo right now. So I'm going to ask that you all move to the front, and we're actually going to map you. Whenever you're ready. All right, you're good to go. All right. You can land. Okay, so I'm going to ask that you come back over here to take a look at the results from the base station. So one thing I want to point out is that this room is very large, and a lot of things, particularly the back wall, are out of range of the Kinect, so the only things we're really able to map are what's right in front of us. But as you can see from this result, if you ignore the little bit of the tent that we happen to catch, which is this green blob, you can see that what we have is we have a 3D map of everyone that was standing in front of the system. And this was built in real time, just as the quadrotor moved. You can also see we use the Kinect data to track the quadrotor's position as it moves, and that's determined by these markers. So, now granted, this may not be the best environment to demonstrate the full potential of our system, so we're also going to show you a video of perhaps a more realistic test environment. So what this is, right here we just have a handheld video of the Kinect taking off the quadrotor taking off in one of the University of Pennsylvania undergraduate engineering labs. And what you're going to see in a second is this video is going to transition down, and what you're presented with here is the two windows that compose the base station user interface. The first on the right is the live video stream that's used to teleoperate the quadrotor. The second on the left is the 3D map constructed in real time as the quadrotor moves. You can see that the location of the quadrotor, which is indicated by this little figure here, is moving as the quadrotor moves in this video. Now, because this is a 3D map, as you'll see in a second, this allows us to then take the result that we've built, rotate through it, zoom, translate as we see fit, to kind of examine details as needed. Now, I'm going to show you a kind of like a bird's eye view of the map that we generated there. So here, take a look here, you see kind of a zoomed out picture of what we just showed you. You see here we have the entire lab, and we have over here something that possibly could be potential survivors or something we want to investigate further. And again, as I mentioned, because it is a 3D map, first responders can rotate the system and more closely examine what they see. As we can see here, these are clearly two people. So now we're going to go back to the full visualization, and we're going to use the 3D map to evaluate a feasible safe path through the environment. And what we can do is we can provide an image that's marked up like this on a tablet or a phone device for first responders to enter the building.